that this election is rigged and that Hillary Clinton is in the process of trying to steal it from you. Your running mate, Governor Pence, pledged on Sunday that he and you, his words, will absolutely accept the result of this election. Today, your daughter Ivanka said the same thing. I want to ask you here on the stage tonight, do you make the same commitment that you will absolutely, sir, that you will absolutely accept the result of this election?
I will look at it at the time. I'm not looking at anything now. I'll look at it at the time. What I've seen is so bad. First of all, the media is so dishonest and so corrupt, and the pile-on is so amazing. The New York Times actually wrote an article about it that they don't even care. It's so dishonest, and they've poisoned the minds of the voters. But unfortunately for them, I think the voters are seeing through it. I think they're going to see through it. We'll find out on November 8th, but I think they're going to see through it.
But, sir, there's
If you look, excuse me, Chris, if you look at your voter rolls, you will see millions of people that are registered to vote. Millions. This isn't coming from me. This is coming from Pew Report and other.
Certainly, if I don't win, I don't win. I mean, you know, I go on and do other things. I think it would be a very sad thing for our country.
But, sir, there is a tradition in this country. In fact, one of the prides of this country is the peaceful transition of power, and that no matter how hard fought a campaign is, that at the end of the campaign, that the loser concedes to the winner. Not saying that you're necessarily going to be the loser or the winner, but that the loser concedes to the winner and that the country comes together in part for the good of the country. Are you saying you're not prepared now to commit to that principle?
What I'm saying is that I will tell you at the time. I'll keep you in suspense.
The big concern I've got is how are you going to make sure that the election is fair and free from fraudulent absentee votes and mail-in ballots? That's the concern I've got.
Certainly, if I don't win, I don't win. I mean, you know, I go on and do other things. I think it would be a very sad thing for our country.
I think it's the most important question I'll be asked, because it's a great question. So now we have a mail-in thing. And you see California, he's sending out millions and millions of ballots. Where are they going? Where aren't they going? Is the postman going to hand them out? Are they going to take them out of the mailboxes?
He said that he believes that you will steal the election. And if you don't win, he thinks that military will escort you from the White House.
Look, certainly if I don't win, I don't win. I mean, you know, I go on and do other things. I think it would be a very sad thing for our country.
The other thing, Mark, it's very important. You get to foreign countries, you know, they keep talking, oh, Russia, China, this, especially China, not Russia, especially China. Are they going to print millions of ballots using the exact same paper, using the exact same machines? And are they going to print ballots and then hand them in? And all of a sudden, it's the biggest risk we have, the mail-in ballot. Not so much the absentee ballot, because an absentee, like I'm in the White House and I have to vote in Florida, et cetera, et cetera. You're absentee, it's okay. But people go through a process for that. You know, it's really pretty good. But the mail-in ballots, they mail them to anybody, and they send them out by the millions. I think I read over 30 million ballots are going to be sent out in California. Where are they going?
Certainly, if I don't win, I don't win. I mean, you know, I go on and do other things. I think it would be a very sad thing for our country.
Nobody's standing there watching you vote.